Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Big Yak Monthly Cup. It is edition number 2 today of the month of August, so the second out of 3 weekly qualifiers. Format is going to be the same as previous week. It is basically going to be working like a bone cup, you could say. So we're going to be using random maps that I randomized from Trackmania Exchange that are unknown to everybody else, so nobody knows what's coming up for them. And on each map, we're going to have one short warm-up, and then we're going to play 3 rounds. And in each round, people can accumulate points and, basically collect points over the maps. At some point, they reach the point limit of 6,969 points, which is a very nice time limit, by the way. Once they reach the point limit, they will be in finalist mode, and in the finalist mode, basically, they need to win one more round against 100 plus other players in order to close out the match. The top 3 of the tournament today will be instantly qualified for the monthly final, which is going to take place in 2 weeks, where we will have prizes for the top 3 worth around 400 euros, so quite a lot on the line. A qualification is of course nice. It's just about the tournament itself, it's about the maps, it's about the people learning the maps as quickly as possible, and it's about gathering as many points as possible. Good luck, have fun to everyone! I hope you will have a lot of fun. Let's see who's gonna close it out today. The top 3 from last week, I'm not gonna spoil who it was in case you didn't watch, guys. They can also attend today. So even though they qualified already for the monthly, they can still participate in order to possibly deny some of their opponents. And I would say we're gonna hop onto server 1. Server 1. Map 1 of today. And that is called a tricky map. Yeah, by Spike, actually. And it's Bobsleigh. Yeah, hello. That looks like a great map. I'm, of course, going to be hopping into spectator mode. I will not play myself. Let's follow Lars, the universal GPS, for this first round. Or, like, for the warm-up. 45 seconds of warm-up. Let's see. Okay, we have a press forward start. Looks simple. Then we have a jump. Looks doable. Okay, I was a little bit scared that this map is going to be very difficult. But it looks fine. It looks fine. Guys, I'm sorry. Already, I am very sorry. In case this is actually not respawnable, I apologize to the people joining my tournament. The thing is, I randomized the maps. And I see the TMX front page. So I see a thumbnail. I see the difficulty. And I see, like, the records and stuff. And if something looks like Giga Hard, I don't pick it, you know? Oh my god, what is that finish? Holy shit. Okay, a lot of people did finish, but looked very shaky. And not too many are in the finish yet. Only the top 21. Oh my god, it's actually not... Oh my god, it's not respawnable. Guys, I am deeply sorry. I hope you will still join my cup at a later point again. That is actually not respawnable. Yeah. Also, just look at this. But, I mean, that is the charm. This is, of course, like, for those of you that did not notice it yet, this is not necessarily the most serious competition ever. It is about entertainment. And what is more entertaining than 100,000 people missing the finish? So, how many finishers do we have? Okay, but we have 70 finishers. Not that bad, to be honest. Only 40 DNFs. Could be worse. Could be worse. Almost 2/3 of the playfield finished. Okay, we actually won the round 1. It was Jaglano. Who the hell is that? Giuliano from Wish. Jaglano. Okay. Let's follow him on the second round as well. Ach yeah, true. We actually have a bit of an issue with the point repetition. There sadly is a little bit of a... Oh my god, Jaglano has so much speed. Is he gonna finish? Yes, 8th place for him. Very good. Scrappy also in 4th. Good performance by him again. So both of them are gonna push a little bit into the lead. Jekosto as well. 7th. Okay, not bad. And also Marius playing... Marius is still on vacation, sort of. So he's playing on a Giga XDD laptop. Maybe some background info. So Marius not with the greatest gaming setup. But it seems to work. Okay, so far so good. We have one more round. 3 rounds per map, as I said. So let's see how the final round is gonna go. We have Scrappy in 1st place. Okay, 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 okay. Scrappy also just won Cup of the Day before. So he maybe has the mental momentum that he needs. Now he just does not need to tilt. And I think he has a pretty good chance at qualifying. So yeah, let's see. Let's see, let's see, let's see. Jaglano this time with a very awkward line. Has to respawn. He is in the mud. What about Jekosto? Jekosto is whitelisted on the server because, for those of you who don't know actually, Jekosto is the reason for the emote Yek. Because, yeah, Jekosto is deaf IRL. So, that's just where the emote came from. So, because I used his emote... Oh my god, he missed the finish. Ain't no way, little bro. Because I used his identity for naming this tournament, I decided to whitelist him at least. Oh my god, this finish is so bad! Can he please finish? Jekosto, come on, I want you to finish, my friend. Do it! No! Oh my god. Okay, this is a dog shit finish. Come on, Jekosto, you can do it! The whole world just cheering for you! No, he actually didn't finish. Oh my god, I'm actually sorry for him. And oh my god, Scrappy! Okay! Scrappy actually cooking. Look at this. Already a 300 point lead. 3 out of 3 close rounds. I think he was literally the only one to have, yeah, 3 good rounds. Okay, next map is called Climate Change. If I remember correctly, this one had the tech ice on TMX, but it doesn't look icy to me. It actually looks like a perfectly normal map. So let's see. Why don't we follow... Oh, Giuliano in second. Let's follow Techie. Let's follow Techie for the warm-up. 40 seconds again. Oh, we have ice in the beginning, actually. Ach so. Yeah, hello. So we have a small ice part here. And the rest seems rather platform-ish. Never mind. Also... Okay, so we have, like, small ice patches into road parts. Probably better to drive for many people than just a full ice map, so I guess you cannot really complain too much about this. But of course the ice patches are kind of invisible with this lighting, so would be hard. People will need to remember where they are, otherwise the mud is calling. But seems like a pretty normal map. We also have a safe finish, guys. If you don't make it to the ring, you can just go left and there will be a safe finish for the people listening to the stream simultaneously. So yeah, let's follow Kanchika. Kanchika always playing all of the tournaments that I ever host. Let's follow Marius instead. Because Kanchika, yeah. You know, yeah. Nice one, Kanchika. Okay, so Marius on his laptop keyboard. Of course, Marius is good at fast learning. He plays a lot of these kind of tournaments. So even though he has an arguably... Why is everybody dying that I spectate? Oh my god, ain't no way. Chris, of course, also playing for the OK Boys. Oh my god, Marius has such a bad respawn. Ain't no way. He does manage to... Never mind. Oh my god, the mud is calling. Scrappy also just arrived in the finish. Nonetheless, he will stay in first because he had such a good first map. And yeah, let's follow Styx now. Styx currently on 697 points. So, solid start into the tournament. So, let's see how he's going to be doing in this round. Not the fastest start overall, but he is alive, which is good. Because, of course, we have many crashes on this kind of tournament. Because people just so barely have any time to learn the maps. So, crashes are just natural. So let's see, looking good for him so far though, 31st in this round, but he forgot about this turn and is actually on his roof, completely in the mud. Chris also a little bit in the mud here, getting this turn, but he must have made a mistake in the beginning. Oh, and I think he does not have the speed for the risky. No, he doesn't. So a lot of Kanadi viewers in shambles here. Yeah, people are struggling hard with this last turn. Damn, Chris finishing in 82nd, and that's definitely worse than what he wants. But who do we have in first? A known face. It is Scrapster98. So Scrappy once again extending his lead. Limpan also getting good points. Lars, of course, also playing today again, even though he is qualified, because Lars is a macher and he supports my tournaments. Good focus, Lars. And that is how the top four is looking right now. Scrappy with a comfortable lead going into the last round of this map. And I would say, while we spectate Aaron for the first round, I can explain a little bit more how the point system is going to work. Because I said earlier already, each month of the Big Egg Monthly Cup is going to have 3 weekly qualifiers and 1 monthly final. And yeah, as the names already suggest, in the 3 weekly qualifiers, you can basically qualify to the monthly final. And the way it works is that in each monthly qualifier, weekly qualifier, you can win points towards a monthly leaderboard. And the way it works is basically the top 3 of each weekly qualifier are automatically qualified. They technically don't have to play any other qualifier anymore. They are just qualified. So if the ranking would stay the same, Scrappy, Limpan, and Techie would be qualified to the monthly final. Then, since we don't only play the top three finalists out, but instead the top five, fourth and fifth place win a huge amount of points. So let's say, let me quickly wait until the points here update. Scrappy with another win, a Scrappy cooking, holy moly. Nice to see that, nice to see that. Okay, so if it stays like this, Scrappy, Lars, and Pepe in this case would be insta-qualified. Techie would be fourth, and Techie would win 15,000 points. So a lot of points. And then the fifth place, who would be Limpan at the moment, would win 10,000 points. So they win a large amount of points. Oh my god, what did I... What is this map here? Ibo said it was summer. Yeah, this looks like a great map. And yeah, so basically, fourth place, 15,000 points. Fifth place, 10,000 points. Then everybody who got finalist mode but without closing it out will win 7,500 points towards the leaderboard. And then all of the other players will basically earn the amount of points which they had when the cup ended. So let's say the cup ended, the top 5 finalists were played out. Aaron had 6,000 points. That means Aaron will win 6,000 points towards the monthly leaderboard. And this looks like a high quality map that that I put up here. Holy moly, this looks great. What is up with this map? Are people finishing? Yes, okay, some people are finishing. That is nice. So the map is doable. Nice. And yeah, to make it a bit more visible, we also have a website, actually, which displays the current standings of each month. So you see Skander, Lars, and Elkhorn qualified last week, and then you see the points of each player. And basically, the points of all weekly qualifiers are being added up together. And then, yeah, overall, 20 players will make it to the monthly final. Not too complicated. And you actually need to make it into this gap here. I didn't even see that. That looks absolutely nasty. Yeah, people are still fighting here. Let's follow Chris on his adventure. But this might have some different people getting into the top places. I don't expect, for example, Scrappy to do particularly well here. Oh my god, this looks very difficult, actually. Holy moly, what a dogshit map. What a dogshit map that I randomized here. Scrappy with 300 points, honestly, pretty solid still. And I need to, like, aim the steering to get into this here. Chris definitely struggling a little bit here. Wait, do you not get this checkpoint? Oh, you don't get this checkpoint. Oh my god, you don't. Oh my god. Okay, this map is absolutely horrible. This checkpoint here, which you can see, this checkpoint here that is in the water is actually flying. So you need to, like, it's only at the top here, basically. It's super, super chaotic. Super, super chaotic. Holy moly. Okay, Chris found a strat. Chris also got the checkpoint. Okay, Chris up to a good round here. He is currently in, like, fifth place or something. Chris really cooking. Many other players are doing good as well, though. Seems like people have figured out what to do here. We have some plastic wall banks on the ground. And a 12th place for Chris. Can't complain about that, I would say. Absolutely bullshit map here. That is for sure. So yeah, this definitely shuffles the leaderboard around a little bit. Holy moly, aim. But Scrappy still comfortably in first. Lars catching up. Techie also catching up. And Elkhorn as well. Let's take a look at Hobbit. Hobbit also playing here. Let's see what he is gonna cook. He is going up. Is he gonna make it into the Toastbrot? Yes, he is. And he's also getting the CP. Okay. Good one by Hobbit here. Didn't have the greatest start, but looking pretty juicy for him. Semi-fine. Oh, Scrappy, okay! And what the hell? Scrappy with a 19.8. What the hell did he do? Huh? He's 4 seconds ahead. What is this? Okay. Also, am I stupid? The first two rounds on this map were night mood. And now we have day mood. The map was dark in the first two rounds, or am I stupid? I hope the next map is a bit more normal again to not scare away even more players. And we have a map which is called Identity Theft by Tsai. And it's a royal map. Hello! It is a royal map, ladies and gentlemen. And don't we even have a royal player on the server? Don't we have Delete? Where's Delete? Delete is a royal player. Here. The chance that he knows the map is not that low. Two maps in a row by Tsai. Wait, Tsai, how did I randomize two of your maps? Okay, well, first of all, what is this royal map here? Royal maps are usually quite hard, but it's a green map, so it should be fine. Seems like we have Reactor Penalty Grass. Okay, should be doable. Okay, okay. Simple map, of course. quite a quick one, 10 seconds long only. So yeah, but Free Will Grass is difficult because you cannot really release, and breaking also is like a little bit yak. I'm gonna be spectating the lead just to see. He also has the second local record. But the thing is, even if he knows the map, I don't think it's that big of an advantage. Because it's a very short map, and it's actually not an advantage at all. The lead with a bonk. Yeah, amazing. And the lead is fully in the mud. Understandable. We have Fredwolf and Bohemius tied in first place. Actually, at the same time. Interesting. And Fredwolf winning because of time, because of name diff. That's actually funny. Like, Fredwolf usually is called Fredwolf, obviously, starting with an F. But he renamed to A-A-A-A-A Fredwolf. And because of the A, he got more points than Bohemius. That's actually interesting. Okay, Chris. What is Chris gonna cook? Is he gonna survive? Lines look clean, actually. Oh, it looks very clean for Chris. And he's in second. Okay. Chris with a second place. Very respectable. On such an easy map. That is really good for him. Points for finalist are 6,969. So 6969 for finalist is what you need. Oh, Scrappy clipped the hole, I think. He got a small slowdown. Still solid points for him. And yeah, Techie this time with good points. Auris winning the round. Auris tied with Skydrew. Once again, we have a tie. But Auris with the name diff. It's actually funny. So many name diffs. Okay, but that was it already with our royal map of the of the session here. Identity Theft by Tsai, and I'm pretty sure this was now the last map by Tsai. Do you know how rare that is? We have, like, there is like 500,000 maps uploaded to Trackmania Exchange, of which I am randomizing the maps of this tournament. Two in a row are by the same mapper. That's actually crazy. Well, interesting. So, Scrappy having a comfortable lead, 300 points ahead of second. Who is actually in second? I didn't even see it. It is, oh my god, what is this? Kek L built a snow dirt. Yeah, this looks great. So this is ice with dirt mixed in between. So it's slightly different physics. Second is Pepper, actually. And Pepper, good lead over the others as well. So yeah, very yak map. We have Elkon, a certified specialist for weird shit. So let's see. Is it only ice or is it like... What is it? Is it ice or is it like different physics? I cannot really tell. In a way, it's actually just normal ice, but like dank ice. It's just ice. It is just ice and it's just Jack. And who is winning the warm-up? It is Scrappy 98. Never mind, it's Bleff because Scrappy had a terrible finish. Very, very crazy maps here. Let's take a look at Giuliano. Giuliano is usually pretty solid at ice, if I recall correctly. So let's see. Giuliano not opting for a 360. And that seems to be a good idea. Getting good lines down here. People are going for the 360. Some people are overwalling. And look at Giuliano. Giuliano with a solid line here. And that looks like a safe top 10 for him. Ice slide into the finish. Backwards finish. And fifth place. And who do we have in first? It is Techie, actually. And Techie is really cooking. A crazy. Crazy performance by Techie as well so far. Doing really, really good. People riding minus minus. Great. The map has 19 thumbs down and 0 thumb up votes by now. So, literally, everybody hates this. So, yeah. Great map. And yeah, let's see. Let's follow Intax. Intax, one of the best mappers in the game. Also, a really good player. Really cool to see him playing. So, shout out to Intax, if he's listening. And solid round by him, I would say. 20th. Can't complain too much about it, I would say. So yeah, looking solid for him. So next round, who do we follow now? Let's follow Yekosto. Yekosto happens to be on my hotkey. So let's see. Oh my god, Yekosto is getting the Gears of Doom. Holy moly. That is not looking good for Yekosto. He is going to end up in like 80th or something. That is not very nice. 70th. Not even 69th. But still, okay, can happen. Can happen. But yeah, Scrappy again with good points. Eh? Scrappy really wants to qualify this time. That is, he is cooking. I really hope he is not gonna... I think if Scrappy is doing really good now... Wait. Declonios with a two-wheel! Wicked. But yeah, I think if Scrappy gets finalist first and then is not being able to close it out, I think Scrappy will not join this cup again. So let's see. What is the next map, guys? What is it going to be? It is Neo Drift Training! Hello! What is this? Neo Drift Draining, and there is not even an... You don't even have to do a Neo Slide here. It's just one turn. You don't have to do a Neo Slide here. What is this? You can just jump out and finish with cruise control. What is this map? So I guess he just built it so you can drive around here and do Neo Slides. But that's for practicing. If you want to drive the map far... Wait! Oh, we had people trying to cut, but it doesn't work. Yeah. So, there is two ways. You can jump out to the side here. Or you can land on top of the road and continue like that. So let's see who is going to be the fastest here. The latest two maps have been really dog shit. I'm very sure, guys. 100% sure the next maps are going to be better again. Trust me. So this would be way too chaotic to follow. So I'm just going to do it in camera 7. Let's see who is going to be faster. So we have some jumpers. Not many though. Oh, but the jumpers are slower. The fastest people are just the ones to go normal. And it's Vredwolf with pretty much flat 11 time. It seems like the cut jumping to the outside here is not worth it. It seems like just going normal is the fastest. Let's follow Elkon now. Let's see what's gonna happen with him this round. He is still gonna go for the cut. And this time he's getting it really good. Is he gonna win the round? Oh my god, the cut is faster. Elkon, clap in the chat. Elkon with the Giga Chat move. Beating everyone on a fucking 11 second map by 0.4. That was wicked. And I exactly spectated him. Okay, crazy actually. Neo better, he says. Neo slide better, he says. Holy moly, what a map. In the meantime, Scrappy's still in first. Pup Bear still in second. Pup Bear doing really well. That is good for him. Very cool to see that. And yeah, let's follow Aaron this time. Is he going to go for the cut? No, Aaron is going for a normal jump and getting a really bad line, to be honest. Not a lot of speed here. Intax and Elkon made it again. What the fuck? That is crazy, actually. That is crazy. And I mean, the other times are, of course, very, very stacked. Because, I mean, there is just not a lot happening on this map. So, will we have a better map now? Come on. The thing is, wait, people are trying to cut. The thing is, with the maps being really short, this tournament could be over in 10 minutes. Oh my god, what did I... I wish I had this randomized luck on... What is Giuliano doing? Giuliano, you cannot cut here. This doesn't work. I wish I had this kind of luck for... Yeah, for Dingsbums. For RMS and RMC. I would say, let's check out on the streamers, guys. Let's follow Scrappy for the first round.
Oh, it's not... I don't know what's faster. Is normal driving faster?
Okay, he is contemplating something.
Is probably faster.
Well, let's see. Okay, awkward gears, but he got the management down quite well and he's in 25th. Okay, Scrappy doesn't seem to be happy with 25th.
Okay, I don't know. But no one in the top 10 really knew.
Sorry,
except
for
Lars.
The maps.
I mean, I did get one wrong gear.
Okay. First round done. Alright, fair
sure
enough.
Here.
Okay, so yeah. Next round, we're gonna hop into Lars. Good luck, Lars. Go cook.
Okay, 4,800.
Let's go,
good
Lars.
Luck. Oh no.
Oh no,
don't
he's
don't watch. Yeah, man, come on. All because of you.
Third, awesome. 43rd, hello.
Oh, it's plus 100.
Yeah, hello. Oh, yeah, Heki, I said. I typed yeah, Heki instead of yeah, hello. Wait, Yami-chan is not on server 1. Okay, well, then it doesn't make sense. Well, then, Techie. And Techie got... Wait, does Techie have Giga Delay? What round are we on? What's happening? Wait, round 3 already happened. Fuck, we were too late. Scheiße, who won it? Scrappy! Yeah, hello! Scrappy won it. And Scrappy is very close to finals now. Holy moly, eh. Actually looking very good for him. He has over 1,000 points of a lead. Crazy. Scrappy also with an 8.9, so he might be safe. Okay, come on! Pray to the Trickmania gods. We have a longer map now. We have a longer map now, right? Longer than 10 seconds. Please. Please be a longer map. Yes. Okay. It's called short as well. But this looks rather doable. And honestly, this looks very good for Scrappy. This looks very doable for him. Not gonna lie. Because Scrappy is good at tech. And he only needs one round to get into finalist. So Scrappy is the man to watch out for. Let's see. Oh, this could be the win for him. Yeah. I see him winning here. He will probably have two finalist attempts. Oh, this will be exciting. Might be the best possible chance for him. Good warm-up. Winning the warm-up. But maybe we can take a look at Marius, who, despite being on a laptop keyboard, as I said, is in 8th place, gapping a lot of his opponents. That is pretty impressive, to be honest, by Marius. Of course, now that we're getting closer to the end of the tournament, once again, a reminder, the top 5 are played out. Top 3 will be insta-qualified. 4th and 5th place will win a good amount of points. And then all of the players who get into finalist mode without closing it out also will get a small bonus in terms of the points. So people will want to get into finalist, especially even if they cannot close it out. Still, like, getting into it in the first place already gives you a little bit of a bonus. And we have Scrappy, the first finalist of the tournament. He has a huge gap over the others. He will have multiple free attempts. He won the warm-up, he won the first round. Will he be the winner of the Big Jack Monthly Cup August 2024 weekly qualifier number 2? We will see it in 20 seconds. Come on, Scrappy. Pull it off. You won the cup of the day. You are a tech abuser. You can win this as well. And the start is looking juicy for him. He has the best lines, apparently. Just needs a normal slide. And I think we have the winner. It is Scrappy qualifying to the monthly final. Great performance by him. Absolutely demolished his opponents, to be honest. Finishing while the others are still 1,000 points away. That is very good. Very good performance by him. GG to Scrappy. Let's catch the reaction. Maybe.
I mean, this map was made for me. Okay, listen, a nice mini tech map. What better map can I possibly get?
GG at Scrappy.
What better map can I possibly get?
Good performance by Scrappy. GG to him. He, with that, is qualified to the monthly final. Congrats to him. So now, it is time to watch out for the others. Elkon sitting in second. And Elkon is already qualified to the monthly final because he got third in week one. But, of course, by getting top 3 in this edition, he could possibly deny his opponents. And he is doing so. He is winning. This round. And with that, he is getting close to finalist. Fredwolf also really close to it. Pöppe actually lost out on a lot of points. He was second before, but now only in fifth. And also here, only 90 points for him. Next map could possibly already clock down the top 3. So let's see what we're gonna have. Is it gonna be a competitive map, or is it gonna be some dank bullshit? Short map by Tizium. Why do we have so many short maps this week? Okay, but this looks a bit more spicy. We have a pipe. Let's see how Lars can handle the pipe. Lars is really good at handling long pipes usually. So I think this will be good for him. Okay, some people fully YOLOing it. Lars going for... Yeah, what is he going for? Hard to tell. He went for something. So then jump out of this, or like sort of jump. And then we have a risky finish. Okay, we have a risky to the right, which doesn't look risky at all. So probably everybody should go for that, guys. We are going to play another 4 people who will close out finalists. So we will see at least like 2 to 3 more maps. But we could already see the top 3 finishing here. So let's see. Depending on who's going to make it. Let's follow Techie. Oh, Giuliano. Wait. No way. They go for a flip and Techie made it. Holy shit. How much do you want to risk? Yes. And it worked. Crazy performance. Crazy run by Techie. Sadly, he is not in finalist. He's like 100 points away. No way. Look at that. Nobody's getting finalist. Elkon with a bad round. Fredwolf and Techie just not close enough yet. Okay, so no finalist yet. But what a strat, eh? That is crazy. Hunting in cup mode, basically. Yeah, that is crazy. That's cool to see. We still have 2 slots left for people to instantly qualify. What will happen? Will it be Techie? Will it be Fredwolf? It will not be Techie. Oh, but Techie, he needs to gain some points. Techie, that might have been a very not so good decision for him. Also, Fredwolf not getting good points. Damn, they need to get finalist. Otherwise, they are wasting an entire round. The lead with really good points, Lars with really good points. But is actually... Okay, Fredwolf... Okay, all three of them... Wait, no. Elkon not in finalist. Elkon close, but not in finalist yet. He is like 10 points away. But Techie and Fredwolf are in. So let's see. First of all, they have to survive the pipe though. And now with the pressure being on, they could fall down. Fredwolf getting it really good. Techie getting a really clean flip. Cleaner than Fredwolf. Techie with more speed. Will Techie survive it? He just needs to make the finish jump. He has a 0.2 lead over the others. Will he make it? It is Techie in second place. With that, qualified to the monthly final. And what a great performance by Techie, man. Holy moly, he really played well over the entirety of the maps. Not like many first places, but like consistently getting points. And with that, yeah, getting a well-deserved second place. Very nice. With that, we have two finalists now still. Fredwolf, obviously, but now also Elkon. And if Elkon closes out finalist, he might deny an instant qualifying spot. And the map we have is another short one. Why only short maps? It is short tech lay by Not a Dragon. We don't have many like tech specialists on the server. I feel like Elkon does have a good chance. Never mind, we have Coco. I didn't mention Coco a single time yet. He's also not very high in the leaderboard, but actually let's follow him. Coco, probably the only tech player on the server who played competitive tech at some point. So this could be a very good map for him. Yeah, and he might be the one to deny everyone. My guess was correct. Coco, way ahead of everyone. 0.1, and he is denying Elkon the victory. Fredwolf probably saying thank you. Because without him, Fredwolf yeah, would have been in the mud here. In terms of, you know, instantly qualifying. And that is some juicy points for Coco. Look at that. Damn. What a point gain by him. Now we also have Pep Bear in finalist. Pep Bear, not the biggest tech abuser though, so this will be tough. Will Coco be able to deny, or will Elkon make it now? We will see. Oh, good start by Elkon. A lot of speed and such an inside line. I think that's the GG, but people come with more speed. Who is it? It is... No way! It is Inferno by 3,000s! Holy shit. Holy fucking shit. By 3,000s, Elkon got denied. I mean, Elkon doesn't give a shit. He is already qualified, but that is crazy. That is crazy. And with that, we don't have a winner yet again. Coco had a 0.6 in round 1 though, so that's still the fastest time. Come on, Elkon, will he pull it off? Will he deny one of his opponents? Yes or no? Oh, inside line, but it's not looking like he is in first, but he has more speed going for the outside line. It is Coco with another win this time, denying Fredwolf. What is happening? The finalists are getting denied left, right, and center. It is actually crazy. Holy moly, man. That is crazy. So Coco, first round, saved Fredwolf from Elkon, and now denying him. holy moly, eh. That is crazy. So yeah, what a map. This was exciting as fuck. So, will we have some yak maps now? The last maps have all been too good. Can we have some yak shit, please? I want a stupid map. Give me a stupid map. Come on. Something dumb. SK005. What is this? Wood? No. Dirt. Dirt map by Kute Gaming. Once again, a short map. We only have short maps today. I mean, I can tell you, I did throw out some maps that are randomized. Because they were like 115 long. And I didn't want so many long maps. But holy moly, only rather short ones. No, like, 40 seconds-ish maps. Limpan lost so many points. Wasn't Limpan, like, third at some point? What happened to Limpan? Crazy. Maybe he will make a comeback, though. Let's see. So, Elkon. Elkon, Elkon, Elkon. Could be his time to shine. He has a good start, but look at this, Giuliano. Chef Julian, what is Elkon doing? It is Croxy winning the round. Croxy was not finalist. Actually, the fastest finalist was Fredwolf in 6th place. So guys, I don't want to say anything, but there might be an absolute finalist fiesta coming up. And we still have one slot left to instantly qualify. One slot left. And Purple just got finalist and had a really good round. He got second. So maybe Purple, who just got finalist, will snipe away the win here. That would be a story and a half. But I mean, that is the thing with this format. It's a lot about finalist mode. It's the same as in Bomb Cup. Oh, but Purple not with the greatest start, though. I see Limpan, Giuliano again, also Elkon up there. Oh, Limpan is going outside. Yeah, that is not the greatest line. And Purple with a good line, but it is Seamouse! Where did Seamouse come from? Seamouse with the snipe, and Seamouse was finalist! Holy shit! I didn't even notice! Seamouse was finalist! He made it! He stole the spot from pretty much everyone! Holy shit, okay! Seamouse is qualified to the monthly final! Damn, okay! Dude, where did he come from?
More points.
Okay, a bit late maybe, but whatever. So, we still have a lot of finalists. Will somebody close it out? Oh, Purple with a great start. Heiko, in the meantime, thank you for the Prime sub. Appreciate it. But Giuliano always first here, but then never making the ending nicely. So, will somebody get a clean landing? Oh. Huh? Huh? Where did Blef come from? Huh? Oh, no. Intax was finalist. Hello, guys. It's the spammy of the day map. Ain't no way, little bro. It is spammy of the day. Oh my god, and what a spam. No, it's a pathfinding one. No way. Wait, do some people know this map? Please don't ask me. This is like the worst map we could have gotten for finalists. I don't know if anybody knows this map. Like, perhaps some people played this. Some people did perhaps play this spammy of the day. The thing is, it's impossible to spectate. I have no idea what's happening. I cannot spectate. Everybody is going for a different one. Yeah, I mean, I guess just luck for the people who knew this map. That's just how it is. When you choose random maps, you can know the maps. The thing is, we do have some spammy viewers. Like, I could imagine Pupbear knowing where to go here. And I could also imagine some others. Lars got checkpoint 10. Okay. Auris also getting a checkpoint? It's Auris! Auris with the win. Lars in second. Oh my god, Lars getting denied by Auris. Holy moly. Okay, I'm gonna spectate Auris next round then. Where is he? Here. Okay, so let's see where he goes. Jumping over here. Blind share. Div 2 is in the leaderboard. Okay, so Div 2 has finished. For the people who played it, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got some good points. Who actually got top 3 in Div 2, guys? Can somebody tell me? That would be nice to know. Oh, it looks like... Look at this. It looks like Lars is ahead if he's doing the same route. But not sure. Okay, Auris is doing something still. Oh, it might be Dennis. Dennis is ahead. Are they gonna finish here already? No, they have 2 more checkpoints to get. They need 2 more. 2 more CPs. Where are they? Here's one. And this here is 2, I guess. And then finish. And it's Dennis with the win. And Dennis was not finalist. And neither was Auris. 103. I think we're not gonna see the 5th place being played out here. I think Dennis or Auris are gonna win again. The others are just not fast enough. And look how many finalists we have now. So it's probably gonna be decided on the next map. LEB PMC 92 won apparently. Okay. Salmon in second and CoPro in third. Okay. Good performance by them. They also get points towards the leaderboard, but a little bit less basically. So let's see what's gonna happen here. Who is gonna make it or not? Wait, what is Auris doing? What was that turnaround? That was so slow. I wonder if Lars has a chance at winning here. Oh, he didn't make the jump clean. Okay, that could have gained him a lot of time. Yeah. Okay, now the ice part. It seems once again like Lars is ahead. And he also is. And Elkon is even more ahead. But it might be a different checkpoint route. It might be a bait. Dennis is also ahead again. Can I find Dennis? Where's Dennis? Oh my god, this is so chaotic. So Dennis. But Dennis is not first. I think Lars is ahead. I think Lars is literally ahead. And Lars with the win. GG. Dude, Lars, did he know the map? I wonder. Did he know this map? If not, that is actually crazy impressive if he didn't know it. He didn't know it. Okay, that is crazy, Dan. That is crazy. And everybody could have done it. Okay, so we have one more place being played out. That fifth place will win 10,000 points towards the leaderboard, which is, yeah, 2.5k more than people who are not getting into finalists, or like who are not closing out finalists. And it's gonna be on a map called Wall Loop. Kanchika, type fucking one in the chat. Is this a full speed map? Is it actually full speed? But it looks like Yek full speed. Yek speed. Okay, red boost. Okay, that red boost is not viable. Uh-oh. Okay, let's see Aaron's perspective or Yek Costo. Oh my god, we have a Giga XTD wall right. Okay, this looks dank. I have no idea who's gonna win it here. Oh my god, what is this map? Holy XTD. Will anybody finish in the warm-up? People should be able to. People should be able to finish in the warm-up, and then I'm just gonna spectate whoever is first. This is Giga dank. Holy moly. Auris! Okay, Auris knows the entire map then. And Auris is finalist. By now we have a lot of finalists, by the way. As you can see, like 10 plus here. So let's see, Auris. This is an Elcom map. Yeah. True. Wait, he's not going Auris! Huh? He didn't go for the red boost? My man doesn't want speed. The Giga Chat, but with that he's probably not gonna win. And it's Intax in first right now. Where's Intax? Oh my god, the leaderboards are changing. Intax? Oh, Intax had to respawn. Yeah, who is first now? It's so impossible to spectate. It's Croxy. Oh my god, what's that risky finish? Croxy was not finalized! Where was Croxy? He has 1,000 points. Yeah, hello? My name is Croxy, and I'm 93rd, and I won a round. He joined like 10 minutes ago. Understandable. Purple had the second best time. Purple got denied. Let's spectate Purple. Anything can happen. Does Purple know about the two boosters? Yes. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, Purple, for knowing about this. Looking very juicy. Oh my, holy. Speed sliding. Intax as well. No! He died. Where's Intax? Where's Intax? Where's Intax? Intax? Intax is in. Going down. Only the risky finish. Is he gonna go for the skip? He is gonna go for it. Is he gonna make it? No, he's not. Who's gonna win it? Is it Elcon? Nobody is finishing. It is Flonko.
I'm gonna save him. Pass it off.
And Flonko was finalist. Achso. Yeah, okay. GG Flonko. What a great map. What a great map, guys. Absolutely amazing. Oh, holy moly. GG, guys. That was it with the weekly qualifier number 2 of the month of August. I hope you all had fun. I hope you all enjoyed it. I hope you got the results you wanted, sort of, at least. And yeah, with that being done, we can check out the leaderboard very, very soon. And I quickly have to let my mods cook, and then we will see the results. Holy moly, eh. The standings should be live. So this is how it looks like, guys. Top 6, insta-qualified. And then we have the following points. We have Fred Wolf with 17.5k points. He got 5th in division... he got 5th in week 1. So he got 10k points for that. And now he was finalist, so 7.5k for him. So overall, if he just has a solid performance next week, Fred Wolf will be qualified. Flonko with his 10,000 points from this week also doing really good. Paco... got 15,000 points on week 1 because he got 2nd. But he played on server 3 this week because, yeah. Because, yeah, he couldn't join, I guess. So he got 15k points. Pupbear got 4th today. So he also got 15k for that. But he didn't play week 1. So actually, very interesting points. And then we have Intax and Giuliano. They both reached finalist without closing it out. Purple as well. And then, yeah, Kanchika, Dennis, Nuclear, Blef, Flo, Skydrew, and Marius. And look at this, semifying, close to it. Cheaper, semifying. You need to cook next week. So these are the standings. The top 20 at the end of the 3 weekly qualifiers. So we're going to have one more weekly qualifier next week. And then the top 20 on the leaderboard, yeah, will qualify. So this is the current standings. And yeah, so congrats to everyone else. Additionally, quick information actually. The top three of server 2, so the BPMC guy, Captain Salmon and Copro, not only win some points, they will also be whitelisted for the next two editions of the tournament. So next two divisions, they will safely have a slot in division number 1. That's also like a small bonus for the top 2 players. So congrats for that, Salmon. I will add you guys. And yeah, with that, guys, we are done. I hope you enjoyed the second weekly qualifier of this month. I hope you enjoyed the maps. This time, very short maps overall, rather normal. That was it now with the weekly qualifier. I really hope you enjoyed. Next one is going to take place next Monday at the same time, 20 CEST. So I hope you enjoyed. I hope you also enjoyed the YouTube video.